I think I deliberately set out to write a puppetry play, or a play that was impossible to stage in normal terms, like in realistic terms. I wanted a magical play. And this was kind of a play that I kind of buried because I just thought it was too difficult to do. And then I thought, okay, actually maybe it's worth re-looking at the play. And so I did. I dug it out again, re-looked at it, realized there was something that was not working. And so what I did was actually merged it with another play which I had started to write. So it became a story within a story. And so it was this really complex animal. And then thinking of this very complicated and complex animal that I was kind of creating, and you know, think of who I would love to work with. And so I brought Mei Ann back for that, and then we got together this amazing team of actors, the four of them. I think also through Mei Ann we got Benjamin Ho from Paper Monkey, whom I actually didn't know before. So Mei Ann is this incredible networker, even though she's not even in Singapore. Like, she got most of the team for me. I think there was a limit, and I think that's why I felt so frustrated, because there was a limit to how much I could work on my own with the text. Just having text, just, it wasn't enough. It was, then after that, it was, you know, having the actors come in and lend their input, having Mei Ann bring her vision into it, having Ben come in with, you know, all the puppetry stuff and all the movement.
And we're asking questions that are of utmost importance at this point in time in the world, not to mention Singapore. So how do we grapple with that? My God. Through puppets. And I say that with a laugh, but I also mean when we are able to have the creative ability of bringing something that is inanimate to life, perhaps we can raise the deadened impulses so deep inside us and our society and wrench them out as well. Kayla, I know, hyperbole. I'm a director, what can I say? Ben thinks in puppetry. That's the way he thinks. It's amazing. You know, this is something that's new for me too. You know, I'm watching it going, he just made a piece of paper come to life.
Yeah.
It was just a piece of paper, and now I've named it, and it's gone home with me. I've held it at night. But just from his breath. You know, it's quite extraordinary. But it's also, how do you write for something you don't understand? How do you direct something you don't understand? So that's a process too. So we had to like learn his language, you know? And I could see the writing changing based on what you saw. And I could certainly see myself going, oh, I can't direct it like that. I don't know how to direct that. I don't need to do as much. I can't direct that like a human being. They're not, they can't block like a human being.
I tell my story through text. That's how I work through text. Yeah. But I think now it's actually leaving the space for Mei Ann and Ben to fill in the blanks, to fill in the blanks with puppetry, with the visuals and all that. So that is quite a challenge also. Mm-hmm. But having, letting the play have the space to have that layer over it as well.